probably including Erika Harris, whose exemplary and diverse background includes end-of-life spiritual care, environmental education, and freelance writing. Through I know I'm not going to be able to say this. It's hard to read out websites, isn't it? EmpathicWriter.com. There was just a space between empathy there and writer. Nobody will put that underscore in, though, online, will they? It's hard to tweet. Through that website, she promotes ecological literacy. She's certified in permaculture design and super Adobe Earth architecture. Erika believes ideals are to be outlived, not outgrown. That's given this crowd a lot to think about. Did you hear one of them said, hum. Erika, speak slowly for this crowd, please.
Life, liberty, and happiness. I chose puzzle pieces to depict these golden aspirations because, have you noticed, the journey ain't linear. It zigs and zags while we do our best to get those edges to fit. My personal hero, Riley Harris Sr., look past his spiffy suit and see a rose trellis, a grape harbor, and a mulberry tree. There's a clothesline, too, for sun-dried laundry. Not pictured are peach and pear trees, gladiolas, lilacs, string beans, tomatoes, and corn. With my amazing grandmother, in Gary, Indiana, they created paradise and planted its seed in me. I walked that rural road to catch my school bus to second, third, and fourth grade. My creator blew my seven-year-old mind when I discovered on dark navy blue mittens that every snowflake really is distinct. Forests have been my gateway. No matter how much you might love oranges, you cannot grow them inside you by eating soil, orange seeds, and chasing it down with water. I know because I tried. The childhood experiment failed, of course, and foreshadowed a lifelong desire for oneness with nature by any means necessary. With its consistent reaching for the sun, a household plant taught me a really simple formula for making decisions. In addition to considering your desire and aptitude, routinely ask about any endeavor or relationship, is this nourishing? Does this strengthen? There is no cure for perpetual curiosity. It seduces you into the art and humility of asking why, how. 27 years ago, I chose philosophy as my collegiate major because even back then, I knew the quest was my real world. Four other important takeaways I learned at bedsides of the dying at Duke Medical Center. One, be fully present. Two, listen without distraction. Three, risk and trust silence. Four, don't offer platitudes in the face of despair. Working and living alone in these North Carolina woodlands anchored the joy and sufficiency of nature. The close companionship of trees, a river, and wildlife filled my heart like little else can. Henry David Thoreau's Walden often came to mind during that magical year. The world's leading expert on ants, E.O. Wilson, and the credited father of biodiversity, was blinded in one eye in a childhood accident while fishing. From this tragedy, he learned to look at and really see the tiny. He's another personal hero. Habitat loss and species extinction, the standardization of expression and beingness, compulsory lives driven by hypermaterialism, the acceptance of violence and suffering as normative, these things keep me up at night. An intense spiritual experience enlarged my perception of reality and brought me into a closer than ever union with the plant and animal kingdoms, both of which have a whole lot to teach us two-leggeds. EmpathicWriter.com is where I practice transparent learning and transformational creativity. That word cloud shows its main topics and themes, and it also houses 4 digital essays available on Amazon that I'll tell you a little more about. 1/4 of the people in this room or watching this presentation online were born with a neurological trait called sensory processing sensitivity. It amplifies all sensory experiences, which is often pleasurable and sometimes downright awful. This essay brings clarity and dignity to the trait. There's a relationship between author and authority. Introducing a concept I call the law of inscription, this essay builds the bridge between the two, with the ultimate goal of this journey being self-rulership. A liberated life and career starts with a decolonized mind. This essay supports those interested in earning an income while resisting various forms of captivity and inauthenticity. The irony with contemplative, inward-facing people is our missing voice in the dominant mainstream. The cultural ideal of the gregarious extrovert will be complemented and balanced with the strengths of interiority. These holistic technologies enrich the design process with ethics and understanding of how nature works, minimized work and waste, optimized yields, and a host of other scalable benefits. Why are we not retrofitting our cities accordingly? People have often told me to lighten up. I don't know how likely that is, but through Farah, I will add the juicy elements of story, plot, characters, dialogue, and setting to the more sober issues I've addressed in this presentation. I had originally intended to dedicate this entire talk to the single most useful plant known to us, hemp. But in my research, I learned that Mosley Putney had already presented a consummate PechaKucha talk about hemp. It is so comprehensive, I'll simply refer you to his very important 2012 talk in Louisville, Kentucky, and ask you to please watch and consider it. Trees take 20 years to mature. Hemp takes 14 weeks. The federal ban against the cultivation of this crop is heinous and must be reversed. This single act of insisting on the legalization of industrial hemp as an agricultural crop in our country is one of the most vital things we can do with our political will. Please visit votehemp.com and make some informed noise. Thank you.
Wow, another call to action right after that.